Welcome to Jacket Speak. This week's hosts are Tyler King and Kate Dickerson.
Hello everyone, we're so excited to show you what's been going on this week in the Jacket Nation.
This week, Jacket Speak is going to teach you how to carve a pumpkin. Let's go to Lily and Anna for more.
Hi, I'm Lily.
And I'm Anna.
And we're going to show you how to carve a pumpkin. First, what you're going to need is a scooper and a marker.
And some carving tools, but make sure you have adult supervision when using the carving tools.
First, we're going to remove the seeds from the pumpkin. So next, what you're gonna do is you're gonna pick out a design from your design book. I think we should do this one.
Yeah, me too.
It's kind of boom. Hard.
So now that you have your stencil, pop all the black pieces out.
Now you're gonna tape the stencil to the pumpkin. Now you have to trace your pumpkin.
So now you take the stencil off.
Now we carve.
So this is the finished product.
Like this video if you like our pumpkin.
Don't you like Lily and Anna's pumpkin?
I sure do.
Kate, you're a junior. Did you go to the college fair this week?
I did. I got to talk with a lot of colleges, and Jasmine has more.
Starkville High School hosted a college and career fair, which included 50 booths from different colleges, local businesses, armed forces, and other opportunities. Students received a bag of informational brochures and packets to learn more about the individual booths. Seniors and juniors from Starkville High School, Starkville Academy, and Starkville Christian School were able to attend. Starkville Academy senior Jordan Crowley was grateful for the experience.
I'm thankful that SHS has this college fair because it gives SA the opportunity to come over and look at different colleges.
Students talked to professionals and signed up for further information about programs they were interested in. Peyton Rogers benefited from the variety of schools.
As someone that's undecided, the college fair helps look at other options besides just Mississippi State and really see what other colleges have to offer.
Students were also informed of scholarships they were eligible for.
From the SHS gym, this is Jasmine Baker with JacketSpeak.
Seniors, it's time to send in your high school transcripts to college. Brandon and Josh can show you how.
Make sure you have the address of the admissions office on the form, and then you can put three colleges on one form, and we will mail those out. If they have an email address and they will take emails, we will do it that way. At the end of the year, we have a final transcript, and that final transcript is free. And you will fill out one form for the college that you want it sent to. Now, after graduation, if you need it sent to another college, it will be $5 per transcript.
The transcripts are $1 a piece. That covers the cost of the mailing. Pick up the transcript request form in my office, or you can get one from our intern, Ms. Walker. It varies with time. Of course, we send them by mail. It takes them a while. And sometimes colleges will have a stack of mail, and it takes them a while to open that mail. So if we send it off on Friday, don't expect it to be there that Monday. Give it at least a week. 10 days. They can turn it back into me or to Miss Walker.
Theater rehearsed for their upcoming play. Christina went to rehearsal to see their progress.
The students in Ms. Page's dramatic criticism class have been preparing for their competition show, The Mental State, since the beginning of the school year.
Oh, for God's sake.
I'm gonna cry if you don't tell me what's going on.
Junior Sally Stafford knows the importance of the message.
I hope the audience learns to never judge a book by its cover,
and that everyone needs a support system no matter what's going on in their lives.
Senior Grant Peterson has been a thespian for 4 years.
It's so hard. This theater has really been a good family and community for me. But being a senior, I feel like I have this knowledge and this wisdom I can give to the younger thespians and hope to make a difference in their lives. So,
this is Christina Baca with JacketSpeak reporting from the SHS Theater.
Last Saturday, robotics competed in their state competition. Jay went and let's see how they did.
The robotics team had state competition last weekend at the Humphrey Coliseum. The team competed in different aspects of competition: engineering notebook, marketing presentation, exhibit booth, spirit and sportsmanship, and robot. Junior Joey Forrester helped build the exhibit booth.
Booth represents our production through when we started robotics, and it represents our production through the year also.
Denise Adair has been the head coach of the RoboJackets for 9 years.
Okay, so this year the goal for the robot is to restore the power grid. We have to put up commercial power lines, residential power lines, clear debris, and restore transformers. Our robot is completely dominating. I feel very strong about their marketing presentation. Booth has gone very well, and our spirit sportsmanship team is doing a fantastic job.
The team earned third place best engineering notebook, third place marketing presentation, second place video commercial, third place booth, most robust robot, second place in spirit and sportsmanship, third place mascot, first place robot, and first place overall, and are heading to Auburn December 8th.
This is Jay Dare with JacketSpeak signing off from the Hump.
JacketSpeak followed three ghosts around the halls of SHS.
Cross-country travels to Clinton this weekend for their state meet. Laura Godin went to their practice to see how they're preparing.
Cross-country travels to Clinton this Saturday to compete in the state meet. Runners have been tapering all week. Senior Lanes Bradling has run cross-country since she was a freshman.
In the state meet practices, we have less people participating. It narrows down to just the people who are going to be training for regionals and state meet. We start tapering our runs to make sure that we're not pushing ourselves or hurting ourselves on the long runs to make sure we're prepared for that state meet. They're kind of more serious towards the end of the year, but also it gets cooler this time of year, so they're some of my favorite practices.
Kenny Dean is a sophomore runner.
I'll occasionally tape a little on my, leg, just to make sure it's, it stays compressed so I can avoid injury. I carb up a lot before the race, And instead of 8 to 10 hours of sleep, I'll get like 10 to 12.
This is Coach Reeves' first year as a head coach.
We start toning it down a little bit right before the state meet because we've had a good long, hard year, but we just want fresh legs by the time we get to the state meet, so we kind of shorten our practices a little bit. We still have the same amount of practices, but we just taper off a little bit and cut off some.
This is Laura Guyton from JacketSpeak reporting from Starkville High School. This is Laura Guyton from JacketSpeak reporting from Starkville High School.
Hey you guys, since it's Halloween, I'm going to bring you some fun facts about Halloween. Candy corn was originally called chicken feed. Halloween goes back more than 2,000 years. Halloween originated in Ireland. The most popular children costumes are superheroes and princesses. Well, that don't faze me none because my mama dressed me up as the Grim Reaper. Willow Smith, Vanilla Ice, Nick Saban and Christopher Columbus were all born on Halloween. Okay. Some shelters used to suspend black cat adoptions on Halloween. Semanophobia is the fear of Halloween. Did you know pumpkins are classified as a fruit, not as a vegetable? A full moon on Halloween is extremely rare. The next full moon on Halloween would be 2020. Original jack-o'-lanterns were carved into beets, potatoes, and turnips. Now Halloween is the second largest commercial holiday in the country.
We'll be back next week for another JacketSpeak.
Yes. Yep. Candy corn was originally called chicken feed.
You have to do it like, you have to pause from like when I talk.
Alright. Halloween is originated in Ireland.
Not yet.
Now Halloween. Now Halloween is the second largest holiday commercial holiday. The most popular children costumes are princesses. Hold up. Willow Smith, Vanilla Ice. We have next to suspend black cat adoption.
On Halloween. You got.
Rare. That is not true.
How is that not true?
Think about it.
Well, we're not to 2020 yet.
It was a full moon. It's the beginning of this month.
It's not on 2020. Halloween. No, it says on Halloween.
Oh.
Yeah.
Turnip, beets, and potatoes.